This is Roosevelt Gist with Auto Network. We're here in Northern Virginia with Volkswagen for the 2012 product line. And my special guest on the show is Mr. Reiner Michler, Vice President of
Product Marketing and Strategy.
I can't remember all that. It's such a long title. Reiner, tell me, what in the world did you expect when you came out with, you wanted to stand in front of the Beetle, we're in front of the Beetle, over there is the R. What do you expect from the American consumer?
Yeah, basically what we expect is we have now a broad range of products, especially 2012 is a very important year for us. We have with the Beetle, with the all-new Beetle, with the Golf R, with the Tiguan. We have many new cars which really will support our growth plan. And of course, in addition to that, the Jetta, which is continued, very successful since last year. 60% up sales from 2010 this year. And now, the Jetta line is completed with the GLI, which is the fifth new car in 2012, which is the Jetta for the enthusiasts, which I think many people were waiting for. So the Jetta story is now complete, not just opening to a broader range of customer by a very aggressive repositioned price, but also, you know, delivering on the enthusiast side with the GLI, which is basically in a notchback, a GTI, a pure enthusiast car, and we are very proud on it, obviously.
Now, you do the marketing strategy for global. What are you finding that's different about the American consumer versus, say, European consumers?
Yeah, basically, you see this also what we then decided for Jetta as well as for Passat, in especially the needs on space, on size.
For the American consumer?
For the American consumer are different. So, you know, we gave both cars, Jetta as well as Passat, more rear legroom. Also, the rear seat bench is more important in the United States. In addition, of course, we added to the respective cars pure US features, like remote control, like 100% Bluetooth in the Passat. And when it comes to calibrations, pedal mapping of a gas pedal and so on, the way, you know, you feel the car, we do certain things more appropriate for the driving conditions in North America. Nevertheless, we keep the soul of the VW brand, which is high craftsmanship on the body exterior, a robust engineered design, and also, you know, very important driving dynamics, which is one of our very important brand pillars. So, you know, a nice combination of doing things specific for the needs of the US customer, at the same time keeping the soul of the VW brand.
Now, you can't talk about all of the different features of a particular car or the Volkswagen product line overall. What is it that you're going to kind of hone in on or really highlight for Volkswagen in your marketing presentations?
Yeah, basically what I would like to highlight is really the Beetle, which is connecting people, which is more than just a product, which is for us very important because it really pushes the emotional side. I think it also confirms the long history Volkswagen has in North America. Almost everybody I meet here in the country has a story to tell about the Beetle, whether it's been the uncle, the grandpa, or, you know, even younger people who have a very old one, or have a Beetle from the 98 series. And I think what we do with this car is really catching up with this iconic style, where we really went back to the proportions of the original Beetle, the iconic Beetle, and that's certainly super interesting for the brand to catch up with the old times and this great success we had earlier when also the market share was much higher.
Now, I'm sure you've probably heard this, and I think in your marketing and advertising and probably behind closed doors, there's something you want to change. The Beetle is dubbed in the United States as a chick or female, a woman's car. Yeah. What's bad about that when they can buy so many products?
No, the point is not at all. I think, you know, and this debate comes up sometimes. The Beetle is a car for everybody. Nothing with demographics, young and old, male or female. And obviously the car we made it, we did this time is more masculine. And it's very sporty, a big stance. You know, we lowered the roof a little bit by half an inch, but at the same time increased width by 3.3 inches. So it has a great stand, nice body to wheel relationship. We moved the A-pillar foot backwards. The roof is long running, so very coupish. And I think, you know, it's appealing to, as I said, older people, younger people, male and female. And I would think, you know, and I'm a father of three daughters and married to a beautiful wife with her own understanding, her own opinion. I think nobody wants to see be seen in a certain car.
Right.
And that's why I think it's independent. And yes, we move it more to the masculine side, but I would say at the same time also more to the neutral side. Also, you know, with great features like on the turbo, the 200 horse engine, sport chassis, spoiler, and a lot of nice features going along with a real sporty car that is going for more for those enthusiasts, be it male or female.
Now, you have, like I said, you have a very extensive product line. The Routon, very seldom you see commercials or the product even talked about. EOS, great looking hardtop convertible. What are you all going to do to get more customers in to test drive those cars?
I mean, the point is exactly what we do right now is, you know, get the people to know better that we are a full line manufacturer, that we have a wide range of cars and products which really appeals to, and there's almost for everybody a product. On the other hand, on the marketing dollars, you have to really, you know, focus on certain vehicles. And obviously, you know, the core pillars of our volume and our growth plan is Passat, Jetta, Beetle, and Tiguan. And then, of course, you have to manage. The other cars are great cars. I mean, we talked this morning about CC as well as on EOS. Great cars, also upscale, moving the brand more to little premium, because we just don't want to be the average volume manufacturer. We really want to be the premium under the volume manufacturer. Then a CC plays an important role, as well as the EOS or a Touareg. On the other hand, as said, you know, you have to focus, be very focused in your marketing approach. And that's why we have to manage through this. If I would have, or we would have more, we would also push more on these, but it's basically, you know, really, you know, you have to balance it out. Nevertheless, I think these cars are very important to the portfolio, and people, as they move through life stages, it's important to have those cars on board. Be it a 7-seater Routon, or be it a convertible, very nice convertible with the EOS, you know, with a hardtop, only hardtop in the market, with a sunroof integrated, nice engineering idea and solution, or be it a CC, which is a four-door coupe car, a coupe, which really, you know, tips onto the luxury premium brands, which really is a proof case that you get more with VW, and the VW is really the premium under the volume makes.
Now, you may not answer the next question, but I hope you do. What did Volkswagen learn from introducing the Phaeton in the U.S. marketplace?
The Phaeton is first of all a time ago, before, you know, we sort of readjusted our strategy, and we talked also about that we now listen much more to the customer, that we do the cars in the way that we really get into the cars what the customer needs. The Phaeton, nevertheless, I think also in very successful right now in China, is a real proof case that VW as an organization can come up with such a car. So I would not underestimate the importance of a car in the growth and in the growth of abilities and development of the company. But like you said, you know, I don't want to get too deep into this. We have so much to do right now. Focus on Passat, Jetta, Beetle, and that is really, you know, what the organization have to focus on right now.
Tell me, what puts a big smile on Reiner's face when you see the new Beetle?
Yeah,
I don't want your marketing pitch. What really puts a smile on your face?
No, but what puts a smile on my face is really, I drove it here in Virginia, very curvy road, up and downs. I mean, sitting in a car, a belt line a little higher, like in a race car, and with a turbo, it's so much fun. And when you drive it, there's also a sound tuning with it. I mean, we didn't mention that much, but whoever drove it heard that. A very nice sound tuning, And it's like, and that puts my smile on. It's really fun to drive. And if you are in cars and you like to drive cars, especially on curvy roads, I mean, you got to try it. It's really, and that's my, that makes me most smile, you know. I mean, just thinking of driving.
Great, Ryan. Thanks for your time.
Thank you very much.
This is Roosevelt Gist with Auto Network. We're here in Northern Virginia with Volkswagen for the launch of the 2012 full product line. And as always, please buckle up. Don't drink and drive. See you next time. Thank you, sir. Appreciate your time.